We are people created, chosen by God. Then we're washed ever gently in mercy and love. Sin has power no more. Jesus opened the door to a fountain bringing healing and wholeness and more.
Awakens, awakens, awakens. Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside us. We cannot contain. Your love will surely come find us like blazing wildfire, singing your name. God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have surrendered to your design. May this offering stretch across the skies. These hallelujahs be multiplied. Like radiant diamond bursting inside us, we cannot contain. Your love will surely come find us like blazing wildfire, singing your name, God of mercy.
Water of belonging.
The book of memory.
The bread of life.
Jesus, light for our journey.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Well, good morning and happy Father's Day to all fathers out there and to those who are father figures in our lives. This morning, to start our worship, I thought we could hear a blessing from Ephesians, or based on Ephesians, that goes out to all dads everywhere. May the Holy One, out of God's glorious riches, strengthen you with the power through the Holy Spirit in your inner being, that Christ may dwell in your heart through faith. May you, being rooted and established in love, have insight, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. And may you know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the full measure of all God's fullness. And may God, who is utterly able, do immeasurably more for you and in you than all you could ever ask or imagine. Amen. Join me in singing our gathering hymn, Sanctuary.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
But we are satisfied with the injustice and discord. You call us to bring liberty to the oppressed, but we do not insist on freedom for all. Forgive us, Lord. Turn us to your will by the power of your Spirit, so that all may know your justice and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior. Amen. Hear the good news. As people born of water and the Spirit, we have died to the old life, and a new life has begun. God's grace is poured out upon us day by day. Come to the water and remember your baptism. Be thankful and live as one who has been raised to new life. By God's love, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Today's psalm litany is from Psalms 40, verses 1 through 10. Please join Carl and I in reading the bold parts. I waited patiently for the Lord, who inclined to me and heard my cry.
God drew me up from the desolate pit, out of the miry bog, and set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure.
The Almighty put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and fear and put their trust in the Lord.
Happy are those who make the Lord their trust, who do not turn to the proud, to those who go astray with after false gods.
You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts towards us. None can compare with you. Were I to proclaim and tell of them, they would be more than can be counted.
Sacrifice and offering you do not desire,
but you have given me an open ear.
Burnt offering and sin offering you have not required.
Then I said, here I am. In the scroll of the book it is written of me.
I delight to do your will, O my God. Your law is within my heart.
I have told the glad news of deliverance in the great congregation. See, I have not restrained my lips, as you know, O Lord.
I have not hidden your saving help within my heart. I have spoken of your faithfulness and your salvation. I have not concealed your steadfast love and your faithfulness from the great congregation.
Here, what the Spirit is saying to the church, thanks be to God.
Today we are excited to have a child of the congregation share a children's music moment with us.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. For this is the day that the Lord has made, I will rejoice and be glad in it. For this is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
What kind of music are balloons afraid of? Pop music.
We welcome Ashley, who will be leading our children's chat, a time for all the children to gather around and listen.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
How many of you have heard that song before? If you've seen Toy Story, you probably have. It's a great song to remind us of how we can still be friends with each other, even through tough times. Think about your friends. Have there ever been times when things have been hard? Maybe someone they knew got sick and they were really scared. Or maybe you disagreed on something. Were you still friends with them? Were you there for them in those hard times? Well, a woman in the Bible named Mary Magdalene was a very close friend of Jesus's. And she stuck by Jesus's side no matter what. She was there when there were hard times. And when Jesus' other friends got scared, Mary Magdalene was still there, always next to Jesus. Mary Magdalene can be considered a loyal friend, which means that she was always there to support Jesus, no matter what. Mary Magdalene led a very good example of what it looks like to be a loyal friend. How can you follow her example and be a loyal friend to others and lead them an example as well? What are some ways this week that you can be a good friend, even in hard times? Let us pray. Repeat after me. Dear God, please help us to be a good friend to those around us and to support all of our friends, even in the hard times. We love you. Amen.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 8th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Soon afterwards, Jesus went on through cities and villages, proclaiming and bringing the good news of the kingdom of God. The 12 were with him, as well as some women, who had been cured of evil spirits and infirmities. Mary, called Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had gone out, and Joanna, the wife of Herod's steward, Chuza, and Susanna, and many others, who provided for them out of their resources. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We welcome Carol Burbridge, who will be sharing our message this morning on Mary Magdalene, faithful follower.
Hi, thanks for joining me today. We will be focusing on Mary Magdalene, mentioned in the Gospels as a follower or disciple of Jesus. Mary is listed among other women who followed Jesus and supported him and the other followers out of their means. That means that she had some wealth that she had control over. There is one tradition that she was a granddaughter of Queen Cleopatra of Egypt and a widow. Other women supported Jesus, and later women supported the Apostle Paul. Her name, Mary, was fairly common at that time, as was Jesus' mother, the sister of Martha and Lazarus of Bethany, the mother of James the Younger, the wife of Clopas, the mother of James and Joseph, and Mary of Rome. The Hebrew equivalent of Mary is Miriam, so this would be a common name in honor of Moses' sister. Magdalene tells us that she came from the fishing town of Magdalena on the western shore of the Sea of Galilee. That name means tower of fish, or possibly strong tower. Jesus would have walked near here as he traveled, since it was between Nazareth and Capernaum where he did much of his teaching. This town was destroyed during a revolt against the Romans in the year 67 and forgotten. The modern city of Migdal in Israel is near here, but separate. Tradition holds that she later moved to Ephesus and possibly southern France. The story in Luke introduces her as having been healed of evil spirits and diseases by Jesus. We aren't sure what that would mean, but certainly she was grateful for this and became a faithful follower of Jesus. There are stories and traditions that call her a lover of Jesus or a prostitute, but we won't go there. So let's focus on what we do know about her. Clearly, she was a committed follower, investing money and time to support Jesus. As Jesus went around healing and teaching, there were clearly more than just the 12. I like to think that Mary Magdalene was one of them, who, along with other women, took care of the daily needs of the group. Maybe when Jesus came to Jerusalem and stayed with Mary, Martha, and Lazarus in Bethany, she stayed at a place she had in Jerusalem. It could even be the place that held the upper room, where they held the Passover the night before Jesus died. Women would not have sat at the table with the men, but served them and eaten later. This part is my speculation. We do know that Mary Magdalene was in Jerusalem that week. She followed him openly as he was tried, condemned, then crucified. The men fled for their lives, but the women seemed to be at less risk for arrest. She was named as being at the cross with Jesus' mother, the wife of Clopas, and the other Mary. After he died, they followed to the tomb to know where it was. The plan was to properly prepare Jesus' body for burial after the Sabbath was over. This was women's work. Women were already considered unclean for entering the temple, and touching dead bodies made people unclean too, so that was a good job for women. So, early Sunday morning, we read that Mary, along with other women, went to the tomb to do the burial preparations, only to learn that the stone that covered the tomb entrance had been moved and the body was gone. So they run back, presumably to the upper room, to tell the others. Mary Magdalene stays to wander around a bit and weep until she stumbles upon a man she assumes is the gardener, but is Jesus, alive. You know the rest of the story. Jesus calls her name and she recognizes him. She is the first witness of the resurrected Jesus, and she is the first to spread the good news to others, the disciples hiding back in that upper room. So we have a picture of a woman of means who supports Jesus' ministry financially and physically, and plans to anoint his body for burial. In her gratitude, she became a follower. Now she is the most faithful. She does whatever it takes to do whatever is needed. Money. Yes, of course. Physically follow? Yes, of course. Chores? Yes, of course. Host a Passover meal? Yes, of course. Wash a dead body? Yes, of course. Tell amazing news? Yes, of course. So why would any of this interest us in 2020? The world has a great need for yes, of course, people. Help with a meal or a shift for who? Yes, of course. Teach a class? Yes, of course. Be on a ministry team? Yes, of course. Bring a generous offering? Yes, of course. Volunteer to support solutions to homelessness? Yes, of course. Work for healthcare availability solutions? Yes, of course. Bring reconciliation between races and cultures? Yes, of course. Bring dialogue between political parties? Yes, of course. Work to reduce climate change? Yes, of course. Bring a smile with you? Yes, of course. There are too many options to list now for yes, of course, people. You know in your own heart what fills you with happiness when you do something for others. It may be big or small. It may be several things. I care deeply that every person is an equally beloved child of God. I enjoy financial giving, making quilts, helping with WHO and with Habitat for Humanity, among other things. Are these big things in the grand scheme of things? Of course not. But like Mary Magdalene, I can do something, and I try to be a source of yes, of course. What is your yes, of course?
Make me a servant, humble and meek, Lord.
Let us pray for our shared world. Expansive God, you bring diverse voices together to form your church. Open our hearts and unstop our ears to learn from one another that differences might not overshadow our baptismal unity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Providing God, your creation shows us that life comes from death. Renew the places where our land, air, and waterways have been ill for too long. Direct the work of all who care for birds and their habitats. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Protecting gods, sustain and keep safe all who work to defend others across the world, especially those working to end racial injustice. Revive and strengthen organizations dedicated to caring for refugees and migrants while their homelands struggle for peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, you promise to be with all who are persecuted for your sake. Guide all who speak your word of justice and console any who are tormented or targeted for being who they are. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Healing God, give rest to all in this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful. Walk with those who are hungry, friendless, despairing, and desiring healing in body and spirit. Especially Joan, Jim, Vesper, Verna, Lori, and Abe, and others we name before you now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Compassionate God, you are with us and we are never alone. Bless all the fathers and father figures who strive to love and nurture as you do. Comfort all who long to be fathers and all for whom this day is difficult. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers, O Lord, and those too deep for words, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you. If you're joining us for our live premiere, you are invited to share your messages of peace and greetings in the chat. Though we are physically distant, we continue to offer our gifts to God in whatever way we can, and we ask God's blessing upon them. Let us pray together. God, you are the source of all life's blessing, and for that we give you thanks. Bless our gifts to your glory through the mission we share. We join our praises with all the earth in celebration of your unending grace and generosity towards us. In the name of our risen Lord, we pray. Amen. If in the work and worship of this congregation, you have been nurtured and fed in Christ our Lord, we invite you to join us in God's service. There is a place for you in this family of faith. I have just a couple announcements for us this morning. First, we want to apologize for the mix-up with the links for last weekend's adult Bible study. We will be having the study again this morning at 11 o'clock, and the links are fixed. The adult ed will actually be meeting in the adult education GoToMeeting room. So you can find that by looking at your email and seeing the link there, or go to our St. Andrew portal and you can find the link to the adult education room. This is an opportunity to dive deeper with the disciples that we're exploring each week. So today will be Mary Magdalene, and also how that then fits into our own faith journey. Vacation Bible School registration is open still for another week. It's going to be a five-week-long program that materials will be sent once a week for those 5 weeks for families to do a backyard virtual Bible school program. The theme this year is Christmas in July, and craft supplies will be provided, so that's why we want everyone to register, both so we know the emails to send those materials to, but also so that we can be in touch with you about a pickup process for getting those supplies to you. Soul Collage will be next Sunday. Again, if you're interested in this program but you don't really know much about it or want to know more, please be in touch with Lori McDonald, and she will also have the link for you to tie into the Soul Collage next Sunday. We also are closing registration this week for Sam's online recorder class. Keep in mind, all supplies are provided for this, including the recorder. Just email Sam your interest by this Wednesday, and he will be coordinating the distribution of the books and the recorders. And coming a week from tomorrow, Monday night, the 29th, will be our first online prayer service. We're going to meet in a go-to meeting room at 7 o'clock, and it's going to be a time for prayer and reflection. We're also hoping to provide opportunities for people to go into a separate room one-on-one with a healing prayer minister who will meet with you and pray with you in private. So join us for that. Again, we will email the links for that prayer service for a week from tomorrow. And don't forget to check your email for all the ways to connect throughout the week. Those are all our announcements. We have a liturgical laughter moment before we sing our sending hymn.
What do you call a cow that can play a musical instrument? A musician!
Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days I want to raise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower and refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to God. Thanks be to God.
lights we can see in the dark. We are rockets pointed up at the stars. We are billions of beautiful hearts. And you sold us down the river too far.
Rescued me. You showed the way when there was no.